Other blueberry pests, and I just wanted to mention the Japanese beetle. Plum curculio can be a very occasional pest, but it's not going to cause a lot of damage to blueberries. Japanese beetles, they're sporadic. Some years we have bad Japanese beetles, other years we don't. We tend to see worse problems following a wet year. So I would say, based on the summer that we had this year, numbers are going to be up a little bit over last year. Probably the best way to manage them is with netting, you know, over the blueberries, because we don't have good organic insecticides for Japanese beetle, but netting is very effective. We can also use a very fine mesh netting for spotted winged Drosophila. If you have a planting that's the right size for the netting, you keep the netting over the crop, you weight it down on the sides, and when you pick, you go underneath the netting. You don't ever take the netting off. Protec actually sells a very fine mesh netting. We used it at the South Farm 2 summers ago, and we had very good results with it on blackberries, which was a very susceptible crop in a bad year with the spotted wing. Last thing is with, did want to mention neem. We've used the azadirachtin for Japanese beetle and green June beetle, and using those sprays, we can flush the beetles out for a couple of days. Usually we'll get about 2 days worth of repellency with those products. And we've done it on peaches and other crops where the green June beetles and Japanese beetles come in. And so that's another alternative. Gives you some time just to flush them out, and it's a pretty good organic management tool. Last insect, you do hear a lot about blueberry maggot, but south of the Ohio River, it's a rare pest. So this is one of them that we really don't need to develop a management strategy around. Let me go ahead and address the eastern tent caterpillar and the fall webworm, because I did not include those in my presentation. Let me just clarify eastern tent versus fall webworm. Eastern tent is the one that makes the tents in the angles between the branches and does not include any leaves inside the tent, whereas the fall webworm is more out towards the ends of the limbs and it webs over the leaves, so it actually can feed during the day. Eastern tent caterpillar feeds at night because it leaves the tent at night to go feed on the leaves and comes back into that bivouac during the day. Both those turn into moths. They're true caterpillars. And the nice thing about management of true caterpillars is we have some excellent biological control, biopesticides that are organically approved. And so the BT sprays, things like Dipel, Thuricide, same group, they work very, very well. You spray them when the larvae eat them. They're not nerve poisons like a lot of our synthetic insecticides. What they do is they're actually proteins that plug into the stomach of the caterpillars. And it's like putting a big donut hole in the side of inside their stomachs. And they actually die from microbial infections of their blood. They die from septicemia. So it's very, very specific to insects, and even within the insects, it only affects the caterpillars. It doesn't affect the honeybees, it's not affecting the beetles and things like that. Very specific, very effective control. If you can spray it on the plants when the larvae are smaller, it's going to be more effective than when they're really big. You're going to need higher rates when you have the real big caterpillars out there, the big eastern tent caterpillars. The one thing I would recommend with it, the one liability with the BT sprays is that they photodegrade very quickly. So the sunlight is will render them ineffective. So the best time to spray BT sprays would be late in the afternoon, early evening. That way there's the whole night for the insects to eat them and get that dose that's going to cause the holes in their stomachs and kill them that way. And you get that whole night before the sun begins to break it down. So again, any of the caterpillars, you can control them very easily with the BT sprays. All right, that's what I had for you.